Mike Papantonio, Ring of Fire radio host and also Florida resident and America's attorney, joins us tonight. Mike, is this, it's very clear that Crist is trying to get people to remember just what happened with Rick Scott and Medicare. Is it going to work? Is the Medicare fraud going to be a big drag on Scott's campaign down the stretch?
Too shady for the Sunshine State is working. Look, this is Scott spent $30 to $40 million to try to move his favorables. His favorables right now are somewhere around Ebola and ISIS kind of numbers. So when that happens to a candidate, he has to shore up his unfavorables. So what's happening this time is you have Scott's last run. He ran against a very weak candidate. He had huge Coke money, but he could actually move his favorables. He can't do that this time. And Crist keeps that attack up. Too shady for the Sunshine State is working. It's resonating because it's simple. He's simply calling Rick Scott a criminal. He's not equivocal about it. He does mince words. He says this is a guy that stole $1.7 billion from Medicaid and Medicare, and now he tries to pay his way out of it, which he did as a multimillionaire after he pleads the fifth 75 times. And the point being, Ed, this doesn't help him. This doesn't help Scott move his favorables, and his camp is kind of freaked out that they can't move his favorables up.
Mike, what is Chris Christie going to do for Rick Scott? Is this a good play for him?
It's amazing. The Republicans already have this brand of criminality after McDonald, after Rick Perry, Scott Walker, all these investigations going on. And you have Chris Christie out there as your campaign stump guy, who's always already very suspect. The best thing he could do probably is put Jeb Bush out there. But Chris Christie is, I mean, do you really want to surround yourself with folks where there's this suspicion out there? And there's a huge suspicion about Chris Christie. So especially when you already have this notion by the voters that you're a criminal yourself, and that's happening to Rick Scott. It's led to this, it's led to them asking questions, even, Ed, about Rick Scott's sketchy blind trusts. Now the media is getting onto that issue. It makes him look more like a criminal. He's got a criminal problem, a criminal image.
And what about the absentee ballots? They are now out across the state. Voting has basically started. What does Chris need to do to get Democrats in his corner?
Exactly what he is doing. Last time, you hear these people saying that this argument about Scott being a criminal doesn't work. They tried it last time. Well, they tried it with a very weak candidate, and they tried it during a time when Scott could move his favorables. He simply can't do that now. It's not a good argument.
And what about these three televised debates? The first one on Friday. How's this going to play out?
There is something that we call in Florida, it's developed, it's called the creepy image that Rick Scott has. That creepy image surfaces every time he's in front of a camera, every time he does an ad. He's horrible in debates, and the creepy image is going to come out. It's going to really hurt him, is my prediction, in a big way.
All right. Mike Papantonio, great to have you with us tonight.